a long one, I know, but it's all you want to know about perioral dermatitis. So is perioral dermatitis fungal or bacterial? It's thought to be related to an overgrowth of bacteria in the skin and is more common in women than men and usually affects people between the ages of 20 and 30. So what triggers perioral dermatitis? One of the most common factors is prolonged use of topical steroid creams and inhaled prescription steroid sprays used in the nose and the mouth. Overuse of heavy face creams and moisturizer are another common cause. Other causes could include skin irritation, fluoride toothpaste, and rosacea. And yes, perioral dermatitis can be caused by stress. Is perioral dermatitis a gut issue? Yes, it can often be a sign of dysbiotic gut. Our skin and gut microbiomes cleverly communicate and influence each other. It's extremely common to also have an issue with internal candida overgrowth and or parasite. I'm often asked, can you moisturize perioral dermatitis? It's best to simplify your routine when suffering and avoid heavy oils, serums, emollients, and use a light oil-free moisturizer. Definitely allay off potentially irritating actives such as retinol and vitamin C. Even products you've been using for a long time can all of a sudden trigger your perioral dermatitis. Remove fragrance products from your routine. Avoid fluoride toothpaste and the sun. Don't use aggressive skincare, of course. Be sure to check your product ingredient list and ensure that they're free from fragrance, as well as petroleum, paraffin, and mineral oils. Spicy foods can also exacerbate or cause dermatitis. Go back to basics. Use a gentle fragrance-free cleanser twice a day and a light oil-free moisturizer. Finish with a non-comedogenic mineral-based SPF. Red light LED can also help settle some inflammation associated with perioral dermatitis. And remember to look after your skin. It's the only one you'll ever have, and have a fabulous day.